Now for the last speech of this day and the session is going to be delivered by Imam Shamshad Ahmad Nasir Sahib, Missionary Southwest Region. His topic is Directives of Hadhrat Khalifatul Masih al-Khamis, Ayatollah bin Nasr Aziz, with regards to our training.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ربنا وابعث فيهم رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياتك ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة ويزكيهم إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم هو الذي بعث في الأمين رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين. Dear brothers and sisters, elder of the Jama'at and children, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. The topic assigned to me is advice of Hazrat Khalifatul Masih al-Khamis, Ayyadahullahu ta'ala bin Nasr al-Aziz, for our moral and spiritual training. We are blessed as a community to have a spiritual leader to guide us and correct us, so that we may achieve the highest moral and spiritual heights possible. This blessing was fulfilled in its greatest manifestation by the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam at the advent of Islam 1400 years ago. This is explained in the Holy Quran, where Hazrat Ibrahim alaihi wasallam and his son Hazrat Ismail alaihi wasallam, at the time of the reconstruction of the Kaaba, made a very important prayer to Almighty Allah, which is mentioned and I have recited already, which says, "Our Lord, raise up among them a messenger from among themselves who may recite to them thy signs and teach them the book and the wisdom and may purify them. Surely you are the mighty, the wise." Allah Ta'ala accepted this prayer of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam and send our beloved Holy Master Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as in Suratul Jummah Allah Ta'ala made this one, "He it is who has raised among the unlettered people a messenger from among themselves who recite unto them his signs and purifies them and teaches them the book and wisdom, although they had been before in manifest misguidance. And among others from among them who have not yet joined them, He is the mighty, the wise." In these verses, Allah Ta'ala has mentioned four grand tasks of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the same task is given to Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam as a subordinate prophet, reformer, and imam of umminkum. And since we accepted Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, then his khulafa also will carry out the same mission. The successor of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam will therefore continue to carry out the task until the day of judgment, since each new khalifa carries out the task of his predecessor. One of the tasks assigned to Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, which are mentioned here, yuzakkihim, which means that he purifies them so they can be closer to Almighty Allah. In complete obedience to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and in the capacity of being his deputy in this age, Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned his teaching to the member of the Jama'at. He says, وہ جو اس سلسلے میں داخل ہو کر میرے ساتھ تعلق ارادت اور مریدی کا رکھتے ہیں, اس سے غرض یہ ہے کہ تا وہ نیک چلن اور نیک بختی اور تقوی کے اعلیٰ درجے تک پہنچ جائیں اور کوئی فساد اور شرارت اور بدچلنی ان کے نزدیک نہ آ سکے. وہ پنج وقت نماز با جماعت کے پابند ہوں, وہ جھوٹ نہ بولیں, وہ کسی کو زبان سے ایذا نہ دیں, وہ کسی قسم کی بدکاری کے مرتکب نہ ہوں اور کسی شرارت اور ظلم اور فساد اور فتنے کا خیال بھی دل میں نہ لاویں. غرض ہر ایک قسم کے معاصی اور جرائم اور ناکردنی اور ناگفتگی اور تمام نفسانی جذبات سے اور بیجا حرکات سے مجتنب رہیں, اور خدا تعالیٰ کے پاک دل اور بے شر اور غریب مزاج بندے بن جائیں اور کوئی زہریلا خمار ان کے وجود میں نہ رہے. Those who join the fold of this community through spiritual inclination and devotion with me, their intention should be to reach high stations of piety, goodness and righteousness. They should refrain from being rebellious, deceitful and immoral. They should regularly offer the 5-time daily prayers. They should not lie nor do harm to others with their tongues or hands. They should not commit misdeeds or even think of indulging in malice, dishonesty and cruelty. They should refrain from all manner of sin and criminal activity and abstain from speaking or doing ill to others. They should avoid emotional outbursts or useless actions. And they should become good, pure-hearted, compassionate and humble servant of Almighty Allah. No poison should remain in their nature. So this is that task which Allah Ta'ala assigned to Hazrat Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and Hazrat Masih Maud Alaihi Salatu Wasalam carry out, and his khalifa in the one sentence, one word, yuzakkihim, that he will purify them. Khilafat Ahmadiyya will continue to keep us steadfast and nourish our spiritual and moral training by giving us direction and advice, inshallah ta'ala. Under the leadership of Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmad, Khalifatul Masih al-Khamis, Ayyadahu Allah Ta'ala bin Asil Aziz, Ahmadiyya Muslim community is progressing in the duties and mission prescribed for it by God. And for the achievement of this grand mission, each and every member of the Jama'at, whatever, old or young, male or female, is ready and willing to offer all kind of sacrifice for the success and to achieve this purification. From the moment Hazrat Khalifatul Masih al-Khamis, Ayyadahullah Ta'ala bin Aziz, was chosen by Allah, the Khalifa has implored members of the community to establish a strong bond with Allah, to increase in spirituality, to hold fast to the Holy Quran as the supreme guiding light, to follow in the footsteps of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and to purify themselves and indulging in service to the humanity. There is not a single sermon, speech, question-answer session or dars that is not focused on directing and guiding community in one way or the other. One can choose any of these avenues of knowledge and they will find true guidance. I will present before you some passages or guidelines from Hazrat Khalifatul Masih al-Khamis, Ayyadallahu Ta'ala bin Asil Aziz, from his speeches, sermon, question-answer sessions, and we deal with our spiritual and moral betterment. First of all, I want to say a few words from the passage of Hazrat Khalifatul Masih al-Khamis to Atfalul Ahmadiyya. On 24th of April 2011, very recently, in this year, in the opening address of the annual convention of Atfalul Ahmadiyya, Hazur mentioned, Ahmadi's life is to establish a living relationship with Allah. So this is the purpose. If he is addressing this thing to the Atfal, it is greatest responsibility of the elder. He said that Ahmadi's life is to establish a living relationship with Allah. And to fulfill this goal, Allah has enjoined the believers to offer Salat 5 times a day. In the 5 pillars of Islam, Hazur said, the first and foremost is the declaration of faith, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah, followed by the Salat, or the requirement to prove your sincerity of belief through regular daily devotions. Hazur reminded the young boys and their ijtima how essential it was for them to offer congregational prayers in the masjid or salat centers as often as possible. Hazur told them, do not think that you are just children. This time of your life is very important. Your future will be shaped by the spiritual education you receive now. Therefore, it is vital that you develop a strong connection with Allah right now. Hazur stressed this point that some of you around 13 to 14 years of age who may come under the influence of Western society may seek independence, as we know here that when children are 14, 15, 17, 18, they do their own. Hazur is addressing that point this time. That may seek independence, but he says, remember that this freedom should not be against the commandment of Almighty Allah. This is the fundamental principle. When you understand this principle, then we can say that our next generation is able to carry out the duties of the community, and the future of Islam and Ahmadiyya is in safe hands. 4th March 1889, Hazrat Masih, when he published the leaflet and advertisement to invite a community, and he mentioned in that leaflet, so main batofiqe-hi taala kahil aur sust nahi rahunga aur apne doston ki islah talbi se jinhone is silsila mein dakhil hona basid kadam ikhtiyar kar liya hai ghafil nahi hunga balki unki zindagi ke liye maut tak dareg nahi karunga. Hazrat Masih Maud alaihi salatu wasalam says 4th March 1889 that I will not be lax of my duty to reform my friends, those who have truly accepted me and wish to enter this community. I will never be negligent of my responsibilities towards them. Indeed, I will not hesitate to sacrifice my life for the fulfillment of this purpose. On the same pattern as Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned, our present Khalifa, Hazrat Amir al-Mu'mineen, Khalifatul Masih al-Khamis, Ayyadullah Ta'ala bin Asal Aziz, has worked tirelessly for our spiritual and moral training and reformation. From his first sermon as Khalifa until now, he has repeatedly reminded us that for our spiritual life to be successful, congregational prayer is an absolute necessity. In his Friday sermon, he mentioned, in order to adopt righteousness, it is essential that Salat is established in congregation. Therefore, it is the duty of each and every Ahmadi to populate the masjid and come for the 5 daily prayers whenever possible. Ahmadis must develop this habit in their children so that our mosque become filled with worshippers. Hazur is pointing to that very famous hadith of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where he said, "Al-mu'minu fil masjid ka samak fil ma'i." A believer in the masjid like a fish in the water. Obviously, a fish cannot survive outside water. So likewise, a believer cannot survive without being in the spiritual water of the masjid. Recently, in early week of November this year, we observed Eid al-Adha. Hazrat Khalifatul Masih al-Khamis observed some khuddam and atfal who are students did not attend Eid prayer. And he mentioned about that. And he gave the advice. He said, "Eid is such an important festival that except for a serious emergency, participation is mandatory. Some students make the excuse of attending classes to skip Eid prayers, but at other times they skip classes." Hazur said, "You are living in this Western society where Islamic values are less cherished. If you claim to believe in the Imam of the age and proclaim giving precedence to your faith over worldly affairs, but then fail to do so, this would certainly be going against the desire of Allah and the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam." Just for those who did not attend the Eid prayer because of college, because of school. Those, Hazur says, those who call themselves Ahmadis need to honor this name and have regard for its sanctity. This is our duty. In order to achieve the goal of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salam and honor his name, we need to make extreme sacrifices. Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salam says, "Hamari jamaat ke logon ko namuna bankar dikhana chahiye. Aur jo shakhs hamari jamaat mein hokar bura namuna dikhata hai aur amli ya itikadi kamzori dikhata hai to wo zalim hai, kyunki wo tamam jamaat ko badnaam karta hai. Our community has to be a model for other people, and if a person in my community sets a bad example through moral failure and weak belief and faith, then that person gives a bad name to the whole community." Khalifatul Masih al-Khamis, Ayyadullah Ta'ala bin Asliz, further said, "O Khuddam, the Messiah of the age is calling you to bring about pure change in yourself and become the defenders of the religion of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam." Advice to Nasiratul Ahmadiyya and Lajna-e-Maila. Upon listening to a report by one country's national tarbiyat secretary of Lajna-e-Maila, Hazur said, "Tell the girls that they should realize their position as Ahmadi Muslim and be mindful of the expectations of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam." He further stated that when a girl become a Nasirat at the age of 7, her mother should teach her the ways of proper dress and encourage her to wear long shirts. In this way, the understanding and appreciation of parda and the benefits of modesty take hold, and when she grows up, it will be not difficult for her to practice parda. Hazrat Khalifatul Masih Ayyadullah Ta'ala bin Asliz further directed Secretary Sahib after training to inquire. In this country it is very difficult because mentality is going like other people. They say we are free, parents cannot ask, office holder cannot ask. But see the direction of Hazur, what Hazur said. He gave the direction to Secretary Tarbiyat of Lajna. He says to inquire from mothers about the level of the observance of parda by their 14 years to 25 years daughter. Their mother should be also asked if they are regular in offering salat and reciting the Holy Quran. In response to a question about parda, Hazrat Khalifatul Masih Ayatollah bin Asal Aziz responded to the ladies and girls. Hazur ne farmaya, matha aur niche thodi tak chehra dhampa hua hona chahiye. Coat dheela dhala ho aur ghutno tak kam az kam hona chahiye. Bazu kalai tak dhake hone chahiye. Jaisa ke namaz ke liye hame hukam hai. Sar dhaap kar, agar tang jeans aur choti kameez pehen li jaye, to wo koi parda nahi hai. Jeans pehenna mana nahi hai, basharte ke kameez itni lambi ho ke nang dhaapa hua ho. Hazur says the face should be covered at the forehead and at the chin. The coat should be loose and be at least knee length. The arms should be covered to the wrist as required for salat. Covering the head but wearing tight or low cut blouses is not parda. Wearing jeans is not prohibited as long as the shirts are long. In this regard, Hazur also said, an Ahmadi woman should not be swayed by the modesty that is widespread in the Western society. This immodesty supposedly exists as an expression of freedom and fashion. The inclination and instinct for women to be modest is from Allah, and an Ahmadi woman should cultivate this and enhance it even more. A storm of nudity and vulgarity has erupted due to television and internet. It is the duty of every Ahmadi girl to not suffer an inferiority complex so that she drowns in this flood of Western indecency. Instead, she should throw her good character and high morals, create such a strong wall against this onslaught that she proves to the world that by following Islamic teaching, she can protect herself against all trials and temptations, behaviors to watch out for, not observing parda in malls and parks. This is all taken from Al-Fazl, from Hazur's direction. Not observing parda in malls or parks, attending mixed gathering without observing parda, overly friendly relations with male cousins and male classmates, unnecessary friendly interaction with men who are not relatives, indulging in gossip or watching indecent shows, wearing revealing clothes like low-cut blouses or tight jeans, working at places where one has to wear indecent clothing, reading obscene books or novels, watching vulgar or morally objectionable movies, dancing at weddings. All these actions are satanic temptations that will ultimately cause an Ahmadi woman to lose the inherent protection of parda, Islamic customs and modesty. And when these are abandoned, the hope of remaining chaste will be seriously endangered. Therefore, an Ahmadi girl should remember that by accepting Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, she has pledged to follow the true Islamic teachings. She should stay away from any action that will cast a shadow on her modesty and good character. She should pray to Allah frequently for protection and cover herself in the dress of righteousness. And for all you Ahmadi boys and men, you are not off the hook just because you are not wearing hijab. You are equally required to observe the same kinds of restrictions on immodest behavior and influences. Save your progeny from falling into the fire. Hazrat Khalifatul Masih Khamis, Ayatollah bin Asal Aziz, says that it is essential to attach your boys and girls to the system of the Jama'at and its auxiliaries by being fully committed yourself. If parents show any slackness in this regard, they are setting a bad example laying the foundation for their and their children's future loss and disconnection from the Jama'at. It is incumbent on the head of the household to save their children from this fire, just as Allah saved them and their elders. Do not make negative comments about Jama'at in your homes. Hazrat Khalifatul Masih further says, apne gharon mein kabhi aisi baat nahi karni chahiye jisse nizam-e-jamaat ki takhfif hoti ho ya kisi ohdedar ke khilaf hua ho. Wo shikwa agar sachcha bhi hai, phir bhi agar aapne apne ghar mein kiya to aapke bacche hamesha ke liye isse zakhmi ho jayenge. Isliye aksar wo log jo nizam-e-jamaat par tabsire karne mein be-ehtiyati karte hain, unki auladon ko kamo besh zarur nuksan pahunchta hai aur baaz hamesha ke liye zaya ho jati hain. In this advice, Hazur mentioned that people should not talk against the system of the Jamaat or Nizam-e-Jamaat or against the office holders in their homes. Even maybe that is true, but still you may survive, but your children will not survive. Advice to the Ansarullah and Lajna-e-Maliya. In his Friday sermon, Hazur mentioned both these auxiliaries are very important in their position within Jama'at, and each plays a critical role in the success of the Jama'at regarding education and training of the next generation. If Ansar and Lajna take their obligation in the Jama'at seriously, then our next generation will be guided and safeguarded and will increase in sincerity and loyalty and remain attached to the Jama'at. If we remain steadfast in taqwa and reform ourselves and our children, then and only then will we gain the benevolence and blessings of Allah. Advice on nikah and wedding ceremonies. In his sermon, September 25th, 2001, Hazur said, we must establish good morals by being righteous model for others. But sometime exactly the opposite behavior is displayed. Establish your behavior and relation based on Qawl-e Sadeed, speaking the truth. Hazur said, remember that an Ahmadi girl has a restriction in that she cannot marry a non-Ahmadi. Under special circumstances, Ahmadi men are allowed to marry non-Ahmadi women. But Ahmadi girls are not allowed under any circumstances to marry non-Ahmadi men. Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wa salam, ye Hazur ke alfaz hain. Hazrat Aqdas Masih Maud alayhi salatu wa salam ne bade wazeh alfaz mein farmaya hai ke Ahmadi ladki kisi ghair ko dena guna hai. Hazur farmate hain ke guna ka lafz aapne istemal farmaya hai. Isliye Ahmadi ladkon ka kaam hai ke Ahmadi ladkiyon se rishte karein taaki apno mein hi rishte hon, Jamaat ki jo nasl hai wo mahfooz rahe. Hazrat Amirul Mu'mineen quoted from Hazrat Masih Maud alaihi salatu wasalam by saying that Hazrat Masih Maud alaihi salatu wasalam has stated it very clearly that Ahmadi parents who marry their daughter to non-Ahmadi men are committing sin. He has used the word sin. It is critical for Ahmadi's boys to marry only Ahmadi girls so that these relations are developed among Ahmadis and that the Jamaat's next generation is safe. These days, various television shows present different customs regarding weddings. Recently, a couple of days ago, a Daily Al-Fazl carried the article on that from the Nazarat Islah Urshad, and I have collected Hazrat Khalifatul Masih al-Khamis Sayyidullah bin Asal Aziz's direction on that. About the wedding, Hazur says that weddings are a religious, not secular tradition, which is why the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said that when getting married, give preference to that person who is more pious and religious. The best advice and direction at the time of marriage is rooted in cultivating and increasing taqwa. One should then only indulge in moderation those practices that Islam has allowed, and one should not exceed the boundaries and corrupt the religion. Huzur further said, regarding the expense associated with the wedding ceremony, Huzur says, there are certain practices that are indulged in with great fanfare, with a great deal of money being spent, and for some reason the perception persists that such things are part of Islam when they are not. For example, Huzur said, there is mehndi, which for some reason is given great importance, where mehndi parties are thrown, cards are printed, and stages are decorated. It goes on for many days and sometimes many weeks. All these customs have engulfed, enslaved even those who cannot afford such lavish spending. Huzur says, none Ahmadis are known to do that, but now some Ahmadi families are also indulging in such customs. Previously, Huzur says, I admonished you to refrain from lavish spending and ceremonies at mehndi parties, but people paid no attention. Now I openly tell you to refrain from indulging in these things. Just stop it. Huzur is not saying that mehndi is prohibited, but that it should be done at home without excessive spending of other things. Hazrat Khalifatul Masih al-Khamis Ayatollah bin Nasr al-Aziz also condemned dancing at weddings or other occasions. He said that even ladies dancing with each other is objectionable. As far as singing is concerned, wedding songs that girls traditionally sing are not objectionable. During a meeting with Waqf-e Nau, a question was asked by one girl as to how humbleness can be best cultivated. Huzur replied, develop fear of Allah and resolve in your hearts that you are going to be humble. Whenever Huzur said, you do something and wish that people praise you, it breeds arrogance. So be mindful to not seek praise from others, and instead, in your 5 daily prayers, supplicate for increased humility. To other question on how to cultivate love for Allah while we are young, some young girls and boys ask this question to Huzur, how to have love of Allah right now in this age. Huzur responded, seek help from Allah in your prayers and ask Allah in the words of Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allahumma inni asaluka hubbaka. That prayer he taught. To Waqfat-e Nau must set a high standard. In his address, Huzur said to Waqfat-e Nau girls, you should always remember that you must stand out and be beyond reproach in the way you carry yourself, your speech, and your appearance. Your parda should be of a very high standard. You should offer salat regularly and recite the Holy Quran regularly. Advice concerning Facebook. One girl asked Huzur about Facebook. Huzur responded that it is not appropriate and refrain from it. He clarified that he never said that if you do not quit Facebook, you will become a sinner, but that he warned that the negative consequences of Facebook are far greater than its benefits. Huzur said those who have these accounts will eventually make connections with the opposite sex, and then our boys and girls may end up getting caught up in dangerous relationship with devastating consequences. It is better to stay away, Huzur says, it is better to stay away from such things that may lead to bad morals. He said, my task is to advise. The Holy Quran says, to keep on admonishing, and those who do not listen, their sin is on them. If the purpose of having the Facebook account is call people towards Allah, then Hazur advised that go to website alislam.org. He also stated that the person who started Facebook said he created it so that every person can be openly presented to the world. The question is, does an Ahmadi girl need or want to freely present herself to the world? The answer to that should clearly be no. I have just given some advice to ourselves from question answer, from sermon, from other events where Hazur advised the Jama'at. I think it relates to our daily life, and we need all these things to follow them and get the spiritual moral progress every day. Hazrat Amir al-Mu'mineen is day and night tirelessly advising the Jama'at to follow these instructions. If we will do, we will be successful. If we will not do, then we can understand what will be the consequence after that. In one of the message, 11th of May 2003, Hazur said, agar aapne tarakki karni hai aur duniya par ghalib aana hai, to meri aapko yahi nasihat hai aur mera yahi paigham hai ki aap khilafat se wabasta ho jaye. Is hablullah ko mazbooti se thame rakhein. Hamari sari tarakkiyat ka madar, daromadar, khilafat mein pinha hai. Hazur says, if you desire to progress and prevail in the world, then my message to you is to remain attached to the institution of Khilafat and hold fast to this rope of Allah. My dear brothers and sisters, in closing, allow me to submit two final points for your consideration. One is the great blessing we receive by heeding the advice of Khalifatul Masih of the time and successfully carrying out his directives. Hazrat Amir al-Mu'mineen is dispensing guidance for our training and spiritual progress. We must all act upon it. Pray, even more so that, as Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam has said, there is a great clamor in the heavens. 2-3 days prior to his demise, Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam said, Jamaat-e-Ahmadiyya ke liye bahut fikr ka maqam hai, kyunki ek taraf to lakhon aadmi unhe kafir kehte hain, dusri taraf agar ye bhi khuda taala ki nazar mein momin na bane to dohra ghata hai. Hazrat Masih Maud alaihi salatu wasalam said, it is of a grave concern to Jamaat-e-Ahmadiyya that one hand hundreds of thousands of people calling them kafir, and yet the other hand, if we do not become true believer in the sight of Allah, then we are double at loss. Hazrat Masih Maud alaihi salatu wasalam further says, tum khuda ki aakhri jamaat ho, so wo amal nek dikhlao jo apne kamal mein intihai darja par ho. You are the last community of God. Practice the good to an extent where it reaches its perfection. In his landmark booklet of advice to the community, Hazrat Masih Maud alaihi salatu wasalam says, duniya ki lazzaton par farefta mat ho ke wo khuda se juda karti hain, aur khuda ke liye talhi ki zindagi ikhtiyar karo. Wo dard jisse khuda razi ho us lazzat se behtar hai jisse khuda naraz ho jaye, aur wo shikast jisse khuda razi ho us fatah se behtar hai jo mujbe ghazb e ilahi ho. Bas apni paak quwwaton ko zaya mat karo. Ye mat khayal karo ke khuda tumhe zaya kar dega. Tum khuda ke haath ka beej ho jo zameen mein boya gaya. Khuda farmata hai ke ye beej badhega aur phoolega aur har ek taraf se iski shaakhe niklengi aur ek bada darakht ho jayega. Khuda ne mujhe mukhatab karke farmaya ke main apni jamaat ko itla dun ke jo log imaan laaye, aisa imaan جو اس کے ساتھ دنیا کی ملونی نہیں اور وہ ایمان نفاق یا بزدلی سے آلودہ نہیں اور وہ ایمان اطاعت کے کسی درجہ سے محروم نہیں. ایسے لوگ خدا کے پسندیدہ لوگ ہیں اور خدا فرماتا ہے کہ وہی ہیں جن کا قدم صدق کا قدم ہے. He says, do not be smitten by worldly pleasures which keep you away from God. Adopt the life of hardship for God's sake. The hurt you suffer by which Allah is pleased with you is better than that pleasure which angers him. And that defeat by which Allah is pleased is better than that victory that invites his wrath. God has addressed me and said that taqwa is that tree that should be planted in one's heart. Therefore, do not waste your pious capabilities. Do not think that God will waste you, for you are the seed planted in this earth by God's hand. God tells me that this seed will grow and prosper, and its branches will sprout in all directions, and it will grow into a huge tree. Therefore, blessed is he who has faith in God's promise. God has informed me that I should instruct my Jama'at that those who have faith, faith which is devoid of worldly impurity and is not hypocritical or cowardly and is not disobedient, then those are the beloved of God and those are the ones whose every action is that of the truthful. صدق سے میری طرف آؤ اسی میں خیر ہے, ہیں درندے ہر طرف میں ہوں عافیت کا حصار. کم ٹوڈس می وتھ ٹروتھ اٹ از فار بیٹر وائلڈ بیسٹ آر ایوری ویئر آئی ایم اے کیسل آف سیکورٹی. اللہم صلی علی محمد و علی آل محمد و بارک وسلم انک حمید مجید.
نعرہ تکبیر
اللہ اکبر.
نعرہ تکبیر
اللہ اکبر.